real-time AI dynamic pricing. Now, what's that? You probably don't realize, but Amazon does that to some degree now, that you can go look at an item and say, I'm buying a tent that's $100. I don't get it that time. I go back and look, and now it's maybe $98. And then I still don't get it, I'm thinking. Then I go back to get it, and it's 105. And so there's a scheme by which you, having looked at things, adjust the pricing. Can you imagine you're in a grocery store and you see a thing that says eggs are 269, but by the time you reach over and pick up the eggs, it's suddenly $3. Or they would say, oh, it might be less than 269. Kroger's is doing this evidently, and they're touting it as being something that's really going to be customer oriented. But we know better than that. Companies usually are not in business to give away profit. They're in business to make profit. And they're going to be using this to get more money from the items they have. Now, one's going so far to even say that, well, they want to do it, but they want to implement it with face recognition and cameras throughout the store. But think again, we'll think of the grocery store, so that when they see me go by the ham, I might get a different price than when person Z goes by the ham. So they're going to recognize the person, and you would say for, oh, this is great. They're going to show you what's good, some possible things maybe that you would like that you haven't tried before. And yeah, that does sound pretty good. But the idea too is that they'll know how much money you have, how much money you tend to spend. So if that person Z walking by the ham is got a much bigger bankroll than me, which wouldn't be too hard to do, that then they're going to get a higher price. And think of it too. What about, how do you feel about, you're Asian, you look Asian, you walk into the store, you go to the Asian section, and the items might be higher priced than when this, me, generic, white male, Caucasian, walks by and gets different prices. I don't know how they do it. They would have to mark, they'd have to have something with the price on it. So when you select the item, that's, you'd see a sign. So it would be the price when you actually selected it, I assume, because heaven forbid that the price would be changing. You know what? Before you get to the checkout. But they're thinking about doing this, in other words, charging when you pick it up too. The idea that, oh, you don't even need someone at the register. Someone can just pick the item up, and once it goes in their cart, it's recorded as sold and it's billed to you basically. Well, when you go through through the main doors, maybe it's billed to you. But and they could have little RFID, radio frequency identification chips and everything, so they could tell where you, if you've gone through the door or not, with what products. And to me, it's just way too much information for the store to have, and it's just another way for them to increase profits while they're making it look like they're doing the customers a favor. And I don't think they will be. Now, I've thought before they should have an app that, I'm in these Hannaford stores. That's usually where I shop. Well, occasionally I go to Market Basket, maybe, and sometimes Walmart, even for a few items, for grocery items. But most of my grocery store items I do at Hannaford Brothers right here. And, you know, they've had major store resets a while ago. So I've gotten used to everything being in a different place. But the crazy thing is when I shop in Gorham, the aisles are in a certain orientation, and a certain number aisles contain certain items. Well, I go up to the store in Standish. We're almost equally distant from two Hannafords. I go to the one in Hannafords, and everything's arranged differently. Now, I think would be a good idea, and still, this is gathering some information about you, but I would like an app where you put all your items in that you want, and this could be one of their, they already have an app that you can use for delivery or pickup. It could be like that. You put the items in you want, but when you get to the store, you put in the store number, and it lays out everything. In other words, instead of, like, I might shop and say, oh, I'm picking up bananas, then I get something else, then I've got another produce item, so I go back. It could arrange it so you could make one pass through the store. And it could coupon you. In other words, if we'll use the ham again, I'm walking by the ham, they could pop up a coupon and say, oh, yeah, 20% off on ham. See, things like that, to me, that would be a real advantage. You would be more organized shopping, and perhaps they would have some suggestions they could put in, and maybe they'd star them or something. But the pricing would all stay the same. The idea is to use, you know, technology that almost everyone owns now, cell phones, smartphones, and use that to make the shopping experience more pleasant. But this idea of collecting all this information, face recognition and everything, I have to agree that with this article that I read, that's way too much information, and it's not going to be good for the customer. With sleep apnea, I have such a dry mouth in the morning, it's ridiculous. But there you go. If you shop at Kroger's and you've seen this actually in operation, please comment below. And like I say, Amazon does that to some degree, that the prices you check can be different at different times, different for different people. So you kind of are seeing that in a certain amount, but at least there, this was one of the things my children said was makes sense. You can have a separate browser. Like, I'll just pick Opera, okay? And before you use it each time, you learn to clear the cache. That's where all the cookies are saved. And if you're not familiar with a cookie is something that identifies you and something about you. In other words, if I go in online, let's say, and I purchase, we're in the ham mode, not that we eat that much ham, but I see a can of ham, I, you know, order it online. And then that cookie says, he likes ham. Now, sometimes the he likes this goes to other companies. That cookie can go other places so that other people, all of a sudden, you get an email saying, oh, you know, how about joining the Fruit of the Month Club? And you're thinking, what is this? And it's like, well, you ordered food online. You know, we know about it, even though we're not the same company. So, in some ways, cookies are good. They are what save your information for a site. In other words, if you go to, let's say, Amazon, when you open the app or the page up, it knows who you are. That's done by basically what they call a cookie. little bit of information and passwords. They might have that somewhere too. So the idea is that it does enhance your experience to some degree in that when you go to a place, they remember who you are, but it can be very negative as far as this idea of third-party cookies that just go out to anyone. So all of a sudden, you know, Amazon has shared with other people, you know, what I like or dislike, or whatever. And so I don't like that idea as much. But this idea of having a separate browser and you know how to clear the cache quickly, you could do that. And each time you go in, the Amazon would not know who you are. And it would present, you know, these prices. And you'd be seeing what it's offering as prices for first time, rather than it thinking, oh, yeah, Mike's here. He buys us ham all the time. Let's go up 5%. He won't notice it. Let's go up 5%. And, you know, people probably wouldn't notice that. So that's how that kind of works. And I don't like it. You know, I'm the kind of guy that shops at the sale table in the store sometimes. And I just don't like the insidiousness of, you know, coming to a place and having the prices different depending on who I am. I like prices to be right up front and to be the prices people charge. It's like, you know, I yard sale and I don't buy a credibly amount of stuff, but I do buy super bargains, like, or even at Goodwill. At Goodwill, I got, I think it was $6. I mentioned this because I saw this in the cell phone yesterday. The smaller version of this was like $30, but this large armored USB speaker, and it was really heavy, and they had it for $6. I looked at it first and didn't know what it was. I used Google Lens to take a picture of it, and all of these things popped up about this company makes these Bluetooth speakers, and sure enough, I found it, and it was $109, so I bought it. Works perfect. I look for bargains, and like I say, I want things to be priced. Yard sales, I don't like to go and haggle. Of course, people love to do that, some people. And then it's a game, like the person has already marked the things up from what they originally were going to sell it because they know they'll have to go down. And then I've actually been in some situations where I've gotten a few items, bring it to the person, and they mark them down as I'm buying them. In other words, I kind of like the prices enough that they had on them to get it. But then when I get there, I guess they removed the haggling, you know, how they had put the items up higher than they really wanted. And they'll say, oh, you can have that other item for free. Or, yeah, no, not 10, 5, give me 5, you know, things like that. So there we go. Dynamic pricing, why I don't like it. And especially why I don't like the idea of people getting all this information and storing it and basically sharing it, selling or whatever it with other companies. I just don't like the idea at all. Tell me what you think, and especially if you shop at Kroger's and you've seen this, let me know.